Hi, I'm Meris, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about the health belief model and the transtheoretical model. I'm going to be following along with our fundamentals of nursing flashcards. These are available on levelupRN.com. So if you are following along with me with your cards, I'm starting on card number 16. Let's get started. So first up, we're talking about the health belief model, and this is used to explain and predict an individual's health-related behaviors. So for instance, an individual is not likely to take action against a disease or a condition if they perceive it as not being severe and perceive themselves as not being susceptible. So for instance, if I have no experience with type 2 diabetes, no one in my family has had it, I've never seen somebody with it, I kind of maybe don't perceive it as being that big of a deal, and I probably don't perceive myself as being at risk for it. On the flip side, if a lot of people in my family have had it and I've seen firsthand how severe it has been for them, I'm going to perceive myself as being more likely to get it and aware of the possible severity of this condition. That may motivate me to take action against it versus someone who doesn't see it that way. There's also benefits and barriers to taking action. If I only need to change a behavior slightly, I'm probably more likely to do that. But if taking action against a disease is going to require extensive lifestyle modifications, I'm probably not willing to make that change, or it's going to take a lot more motivation to get me to make that change. Other things would be modifying factors like age, genetics, gender. All of those sorts of things may change how an individual views their own health. And then we also have cues to action, which are things like, what is the message we're getting from society? Am I seeing a lot of public service announcements about it? Am I seeing billboards? Am I aware of the significance of a condition or a disease? That's going to change how I perceive it as well. One more thing is going to be self-efficacy. And self-efficacy describes a person's ability or willingness in their ability to be successful. So how do I see myself? Do I see myself as someone who puts their mind to something and takes care of it and I get it done? Or do I see myself as someone who's probably not going to be successful when I try to implement a change? Just how I perceive myself is going to change my ability to be successful in making that change. Okay, on card number 17, we talk about the transtheoretical model. And you can see here, I have a nice table on this card. I've got a lot of bold and red information. So there's a lot to know from this card. But the transtheoretical model describes the 6 stages associated with behavior change. So let's say I just found out that I am pre-diabetic and the doctor says, hey, we can keep you from getting type 2 diabetes, but these are the steps you need to make. You need to eat fewer carbs and you need to be more active. Okay, wow. Well, there's a lot. It's not as simple as just flipping a switch and making that change. So first of all, we have the pre-contemplation stage. Pre meaning before, contemplation meaning thinking about. So this is before I'm even thinking about it. This means that I'm not aware of a change that needs to be made. Maybe this was before I went to my doctor, and it's unlikely that I'm going to make a change in the next 6 months if I'm in this stage. After that though, now I'm aware of it. I know that there's a change that needs to be made. Now I'm in the contemplation stage. This means I'm thinking about it. So now I'm thinking of making a change. It's likely I'll make this change, but within the next 6 months. Moving on, we have the preparation stage. As the name might suggest, this means I'm preparing to make the change. Maybe I'm making some small changes, little baby steps. This is good though, and it indicates that within the next 30 days, I might be making that change. After preparation comes action. This means I've made the change and the behavior is ongoing. Maintenance, as the name might suggest, maintenance means I'm maintaining that change. So I made the change, it's ongoing, and the change has persisted for 6 or more months. That's a long amount of time to make a change. And then the last stage, of course, being termination. This means that the desire to return to my previous behaviors is gone. The change is considered permanent. It's just a lifestyle modification that I have successfully made. So that's the transtheoretical model, very helpful in understanding how to engage your patients and how to help them in making behavior changes. Okay, that is it for the health belief model and the transtheoretical model. I hope that was helpful. If it was, please like this video. I would love for you to leave me a comment below. Tell me what you thought about this video or what else you would like to add. If there's any cool way that you remember things from this video, definitely let us know. Next up, I'm going to be talking about communication. Communication is so important for fundamentals, so you don't want to miss that. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so that you get notified as soon as new content comes out. I can't wait to see you in the next one. Thanks so much and happy studying.
I invite you to subscribe to our channel and share a link with your classmates and friends in nursing school. If you found value in this video, be sure to hit the like button and leave us a comment and let us know what you found particularly helpful.